Welcome to Farming Simulator 15. It still sounds weird saying it. Oh, I must have said, I don't know how many videos I've got up before Farming Simulator 13, but I must have said it loads of times. Okay, we're going to carry on in Bjornholm. And yeah, last episode we basically just checked out the surrounding areas and just a bit of a, you know, an amazement and awe of how this game looks compared to you know, the Westbridge Hills on 2013. Yeah, so I'm very happy, and I've been reading a lot of your comments. My phone has been going nuts every time that you guys leave a comment. I get an email, so my phone has been going, rah, you know, buzz all the time. And it's probably by far the biggest comment I think I received is if you press 9, it tells you where everything is. Okay, which I should have picked up if I'd done the tutorial. Okay, so you can see it's a big map. You know, we've got the shipping off. I don't know. There we go. We can kind of see it better with a stone background. So we got the shipping office in the top left. We got the lumber yard, windmill, garden center, biogas, plants, freight. So we can get to places. That's cool. So I don't need to download the map and put it on my second monitor. We can just press 9. And the good thing about this is you can still walk around and, you know, happy days. So today we are gonna just have a look at some of the actually what we're gonna do, we're gonna quickly finish okay, that ain't working. I changed I'll tell you what I just done then. I changed in the options up, down, left, right to my up, down, left, right arrows, and it just hasn't worked for some reason. Never mind. Might as well finish this field off. We're going to hire a worker. Let's see if that works. There we go. I'm glad that still works. Oh, wow. Did I see that last time? I don't think I did. That looks amazing. It's actually not leaving any anything behind. It's chopping it all up. Is there a way of like non-chopping it? Can I press G? Okay, so G doesn't work anymore. How do you change front? Spacebar? Nope. I don't know how to... No, okay. Somebody have to tell me how to stop it from eating my... I'm presuming that's wheat, that new icon in the bottom right-hand corner. Okay, let's not trust it. Oh, keep pressing the up, down, left, right again. Sorry. Oh, no, we got to connect it. Oh, you think I'll be like an expert at this game. Especially, you wouldn't believe how many people sort of, you know, send me messages saying, hey, Stocko, how do I do this? And a lot of the times I'm thinking, I don't know. Oh, wow. My new favorite feature. The windmills work. That is so cool. You can see in the wind mirrors. That is amazing. I'm such a fanboy of this game. Okay, a little bit of a disclaimer, peeps. Today is going to be a fairly short game. Video, I should say, not a game. Oh, look, it's got suspension. You can see the body moving and everything on the tractors. And you don't really get to see that on the other... You know, I'm probably doing that thing. You know, when you get into a new game, you're like, oh, wow, look, it's got graphics. You know, it's like no other game has got graphics ever. So I'm sure that a lot of the features that I'm worrying about, you know, you guys have pretty much seen in 2013. But I don't know. I just love new things. yeah, what was I saying? Oh, yeah, it's a bit of going to be a short-ish video today. Because I am going... Oh, give me your seed. I'm going to, can I press 4? Yeah. Oh, no, it don't work. Oh, I just pressed 4 and I got out. Did I press 4? E. I might have pressed E. Yes, I'm going to a Halloween party today in Birmingham. So I've got to, I've quickly got to get changed and head on up to Birmingham. The party starts fairly soon, so I haven't got too much time to play, but I wanted to get a video up today. Whoa! For you guys, anyway, because the first video went down so well, and I felt bad because we didn't do much farming. So today, we are going to work on the other field. Actually, we're... Oh, wrong button. not you. Okay, we need to find ourselves a plow. I want to see the plowing. I had a lot of comments asking me to show off the plow. We are at the farm. Yeah, we're at the farm. Oh, and you can see the worker working, you know, the steering wheel. Yeah, because what else would he be using to work? Oh, look at that worker. He's using the a pig to steer his tractor. Now, I've been looking into at work, you know, behind the scenes without anyone knowing. I've been looking into a lot of these glitches and the, well, not glitches, but the screen tearing. Looking at the Twitter feeds of Durr as well. It seems that everybody's getting them, not just myself. So I don't think it's anything that that I'm doing. Now, I want to plow this field. Do I have to buy a plow, or have we got a plow? Is there a way of finding out? Let's go... Blow! Blows. You own one. So we own this Cahoon... Cahoon Verrymaster 153. Garage. Okay, so... Where do I know where it is? Ah, something's flashing. And I just tried using the up, down, left, right arrows again. Oh no, that's me. I am such a derp. Do you know, I might not even upload this video. Okay, I haven't even got time to do another one, so I'm sorry, peeps. You're just going to have to put up with my derpiness just for a few more minutes until I find the plow. Okay, well, this tell me where the plow is. Ooh, okay, I want the... Oh, look at this, there it is. Now, where am I? I'm around there somewhere. So, bottom end, just a little bit up from that thingy there. By the chickens. Of course it's by the chickens. Where else would you put a plow? You would put the plow near the chickens. Okay, I can't see that map in the way. It's here. Where are you, plow? I'm coming to get you. There you are. How do I get up there? Okay, I'm in a tractor. I could do things like this. Alright, we're going to connect to the plow. Yeah, apparently the plowing mechanics look amazing. I'm so happy with the graphics. Now, a lot of people are not too pleased with the graphics. They're saying that... oh, look how close I was to the plow. Oh, you guys are going to destroy me on the comments. I'm sorry. Yeah, a lot of people are saying about the graphics, saying, it's, you know, all this time, it's taken 2 years, and, you know, it's not as good as they want it to be. And I am really pleased with the graphics engine. I think it's a big step up, so big, you know, big congrats to Giants and the team. Now, this is where I can't remember how to use a plow. Oh, allow create fields. We can join the fields together. It's great news. Now, doesn't this swing open? Oh, you can still press G. Oh, that's good. You can hire a worker. What, for ploughing? Yeah, you could always do that, couldn't you? Well, let's hire a worker and see how it's done. Right. That's great. Ah. Okay. Check that out. That actually looks like that looks really good. I'm quite impressed with that.
So this thing doesn't like sort of swing around. This is how you use it. I was just pressing H just so I know. I'm going to do it myself now. Did he turn the plow? No, he didn't. So let's turn it over. So G. Turn the plow. Oh, look at that. The lighting effects coming off the teeth. It's just amazing. Look at the mud on the... Oh, I love this game. okay, lower is V. Okay, that's made a bit of a mess of that. That seems to be working. Yeah, by the way, if you're interested, we are running on number 3. So, speed control 3. It seems really quick. Hey, ground is looking good. Now, I don't know what the benefits, if there is any if there is any benefits of plowing and then... Oh, you can see in the wind mirror, so you can tell when it's finished. You can hear the hydraulics. Sound like Terminator. No, that's not Terminator. No, what are they called? Transformers. Yeah. I'll be back. I spent a bit of time then thinking about, you know, what a Transformer name was, and I just remember one. I'll be back. Oh, hang on. You don't own this field. Wow. Lift the plow. Number 3 seems really quick for plowing. Or it's just a really short field. Yeah, I'll be back, Bumblebee. There we go. There's my reference of Terminator and Transformers. See what happens. I just get myself into trouble when I talk because I just say what I think, and there's a danger in that sometimes in a Let's Play. As you guys have witnessed over the years, if you've been following me on this channel, or if you just joined me, this is more to come. It doesn't get better, I promise, so I apologize. We have fun, though, that's the main thing. Lift it up.
Yeah.
Press B. Let's slow it down. Now, we got to wait on our front. Lower. You can hear the hydro... You can check the wind mirror. Oh, yeah. That's probably the most impressed thing I've seen today is the wind mirror. But the ploughing looks really good. The tractor does kind of move like you're ploughing. Although, I've got to be honest, I have never ploughed a field in my life. So I don't know whether it's real or not, but it, you know, feels how I expect it to feel. And look at that, I'm doing two things at once. Yeah! He says I can't multitask, eh? Wife? My wife's listening. Multitask, that's my middle name. It isn't, honestly. Oh. I can just about talk and play a game. If I have to think about the game, then we're all screwed. Because you get derpalicious moments, and I just look silly. Now I could press hire worker, but I'm not going to. We haven't got a lot of money. I've probably wasted £500 pounds in fuel and just wasting time. Oh, I should let that drop down first. There we go. Go. Can you use the windscreen wiper, I wonder? No, but you can. Oh, that's so... Oh, you know, it's a big tractor. I was expecting a bit of a... No. Sounds very girly. Not that there's wrong with girly sounding horns, obviously, but... Okay. I'm just excited. I love the way the cabin leans as well. You can, like, really lean. I've seen a comment as well about so many drifting tractors around corners and stuff. That does sound pretty awesome. Ah, did I spin this? No, I don't think I did. There we go. So clearly I'm not the best plower in the world, but we're going to do half this field and then we're going to get the a cultivator, right? We're going to check out the cultivating and then we're going to check out the seeding. And that'll probably be it for this episode. Like I say, it's going to be a very short episode. I've got so much to do. I've got to go to Birmingham and I'm dressing up as a vampire tonight. It's Halloween. And yeah, it should be fun. But good news is, tomorrow is a Saturday and I'll be gaming all day. So there'll be plenty of videos coming out tomorrow. Plenty of videos out for the rest of the week. It's kind of come out at a weird time, you know, with work and everything else. But yeah. Yeah, I bought this on Steam. I'm interested to get some of the achievements. So one of my goals really is to get all the achievements. Oh my gosh. All the achievements on Farming Simulator 2015 with me, Stockoglaws, and yeah, with this map, I'd like to get all the achievements if possible. I'm not happy with that. Okay. Did I turn it? No. Look at the mud. Oh, this game is so cool. Lower. Off we go. I should let the AI really have a play with the plow. Yeah, let's do that. Let's hire the worker. There we go. Okay. Worker's controlling the vehicle at the moment. Let's jump in then. What's this? This is a cedar. Now, have we got a cultivator lying around? Or was that a cedar stroke cultivator? I thought I'd check in here first because now I can't go up. Okay, so now I can use the up, down, left, right. That seems like cheating. What's up here? Oh my god, you can go upstairs. Okay, I'd so hide up here if I was a kid and my dad was a farmer. I'd like build a den and have a pet pig called Ernie. Ernie is a great name for a pig. Okay, so I digress. So we're looking for a cultivator in one of these buildings. Actually, it's a good thing. Let's just check to see if we've got a cultivator. Yes, we do. Where are you? Do you want to sell? No, I want to use you. Where's the bit where it says I own? It was on the it was this thing. Yeah, cultivator. You're all the way down there. Can you race? Yes. Okay. Oh, fantastic. Okay, normally I would have traveled down there, picked it up and have a good look around, but I am, as I said, a little bit short of time. And I wanted to get a good video out for you guys, and there's the cultivator. And I love my, I love the heat coming off the, I thought I just cultivated my farm. The heat coming off the stack and distorting, that looks great. But saying that, the screen tearing, I haven't seen much of the screen tearing, to be honest. Maybe they've patched it without me knowing about it, but yeah. There's no more screen tearing. So that field's done. Ewan's finished that field. We've got Zachary, who's taken over the ploughing. He was like, Stocko, get out the tractor flower. Let me plough. I was like, okay. You win. Okay, that's gonna... How wrong can this go? Oh, look at... Let's stay on the... Okay, that looks great. Love the way it turns out the way it turns out the ground. The effects is brilliant. I'm really happy with that. Now I don't know whether this done any good to the actual ground. You know, as in like, you know, do we get extra yield in? I don't know if that information is available or, you know, is it the done thing? Do we need to plow in? Let's get in here. It's lower. Yeah, do we need to plow and cultivate every single time, or do we just need to cultivate seed and then fertilize like we did in 2013? Well, at least I'm flattening it all out anyway. I'm hiding my mistakes of my terrible plowing. Apparently now you can actually hire the workers to fertilize, which has been the first. You know, normally you wasn't able to do that. You had to do it yourself, and I think that's where the creation of sort of cosplay come from. I think it was the fertilization of the fields, and having to do it yourself. It slows everything down when you get to sort of a very large estate. We haven't ever had a large estate, so it hasn't really affected our channel yet. But I don't mind fertilizing. In fact, I quite enjoy fertilizing. It feels like you're putting the last touches to the field, you know? You know, like Ewan and Zachary. Oh, whoa! We seriously went, like, Tokyo Drift then for a second. You got Ewan and Zachary working the field. And, you know, and then we sort of just like to check over the proceedings and making sure that the field is up to scratch, you know, with our final bit of laying of fertilizer. And it feels like that, you know, that we've done it. You know, you stand back and go, hey, look what we've done. Okay, it seems clear to me that I'm making a bit of a mess of this. But we'll continue. So easy to drift these tractors. They're like more responsive than the other type of tractors in FS 2013. Now people are going to say, you know, maybe, I don't know, but I'll stop, you know, why you keep comparing it to 2013? But that's the only thing we've got to compare. I can't really compare this to, you know, professional farmer, because, yeah, it just doesn't, you know, it isn't fair. To a professional farmer to try and compare it against this amazing awesomeness of a game. So we won't do that. I think you just got to turn really slow in these things, because it doesn't like really fast turns. But this is great. You know, the farm's coming on, and well, when I say the farm's coming along, you know, we've finished obviously in one field. We've started to plow and cultivate another field. This kind of, you know, looks okay. Yeah, you just need to be careful. Just slow it down when you come around off a bend. I think that's probably the best thing. Oh, you look at, oh my god, I love this game. Can you see the muddy footprints in the footwell of the tractor? That's great. I love that little touch. I don't know. if this is the reason, but can you see the in the wing mirrors? Can you see the little red and white plates? Maybe it's, you know, maybe they're there so the farmer can see, you know, make sure that one, that the cultivator is actually attached to the tractor and you're not just going up and down the field without anything on the back. And two, you know, so you can, when you're reversing, you've got something to measure it against. I don't know. If anybody knows why that is, please leave a comment in the description. Oh, this game's great. Hey, and also I just noticed as well, the do you notice I said hey? I don't think I ever said that before. You noticed the wind mirrors, they've it looks like objects may be closer than they actually seem. As there should be a little sticker on the bottom of the window. Cause it is sort of magnified a little bit. Okay, looks like we're catching Ewan up in the tractor. In the tractor ploughing. So we might need to, in a minute, just go get the seeder and have a look at the seeder. Yeah. Oh, look at the mud. Oh, this game is so awesome. I don't think I'm going to get bored of this game. You know, not at least for another 2 years until 20 Farming Simulator Farming Simulator 2017 comes out. That's what we're looking for. All right, we'll do this last one and then we'll go grab the seeder and take a look at the seeding. We start off with quite a bit of equipment as well, and there's a lot in the silos that we need to sell. You know, so you know, the next sort of, you know, 10-15 episodes is going to be fairly busy. You know, we're going to be doing a lot of selling. We're going to hopefully start learning the map and get some money in the bank. Okay, let's put this away for the time being. What I'll do is I'll probably put it here. Right, don't get picky, Stocko, come on. Lower cultivator. And then detach. Cool. Let's go get the seeder, which is down here, wasn't it? Over there. There it is. You can see the marks in the ground behind me, the tire marks. Whoa. Okay, attach. It's got no seeds in it at the moment, so we've got to fill. There we go. Refill sower. Now we can change, select the seed with zero. So I guess that's barley. That's flowers. Grass, corn, parsnips, wheat. Okay, I'm gonna go for that one because we haven't seen that one before. I think that's, hopefully that's canola, not barley. I don't know. We'll have to see. So okay, so this is where we, you know, get the seeds in our trailer. How are we gonna know what seed we get? Do we have to select the seed before we? That might be a pain. Oh, look at this lovely cultivated field we've got here. Okay, so let's lower, turn on the sower, and off we go. Yeah, we're sowing. It's actually quite hard to drive the tractor, you know, on the outside when you're looking at it like this. I want to have a look to see if you can see the seeds going into the ground. That's what I'm looking for. No, but that doesn't matter. We are sowing the seeds of love through the video. Oh, this tractor's filthy. It's a dirty job, isn't it? You know, being a farmer. There's something else as well I want to check out quickly. We're going to do a few lengths with the cedar. Oh, there's ridge markers as well. Okay, let's check that out quickly. Z. So it's that one, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, I'm off course. So then that lines you up, the ridge marker then basically, if you don't know, it lines you up to make sure that you're in the middle. If you've done this properly, it would line up great. Keeps pulling over to the right hand side, the cedar. Now what I find as well, you haven't got 1, 2, 3, 4 anymore. No, it looks like you just got number 3, and that basically just depending on the attachment that you're using, it will automatically select the correct speed. I think that's the I think that's what we're doing. Oh, I've just... Okay. I've just... let's turn that ridge marker thing off, because... that's frustrating. I've just ridge marked my seeded ground. Yep, full of derps. But I just wanted to show off the ploughing, the cultivating, and the seeding in this video. I will get better and the derping will get less. Don't count on it though, because it might not. Right, let's just lift that up. We'll get out of there and we'll just check. Gotta change the keys. Let's just check. You can buy animals. Where's the animals? Oh, there's more stuff. We haven't checked these out. Auger wagons. Let's have a look at the auger. Auger wagon. Okay, one auger wagon. Also known as a chaser bin. These trailers are their own screw conveyor. You can use them to store your crop and directly unload it into other trailers. Cool. We'll have to use that. And you can buy cars now, okay? Oh, a lizard, a pickup. Do you get it? A pickup? Pickup car? Yeah. 220 horsepower. Okay, so it's a powerful pickup car. Got some front loaders. We're going to check out my front loading skills at some point, I'm sure. Animals. This is what I want to check. Okay, so you still got the 3 cows, sheep, and chicken. Cows got a maintenance of £40 a day. Wow, okay, that's expensive. Sheep are 20, chickens a pound a day. We've got forestry equipment. Okay, we got the ST65T Paratech FSI. I don't know where they come up with these names. That's great. Okay, we've got a timber runner. We've got piece of machinery plants new trees. Can transport tree logs. Okay, I've seen that. We've seen that in the videos. This machine breaks trunks into chips. Wow. Okay, and we got the Ponsse buffalo. And the Scorpion King, which is this thing here, the vehicle could transport tree logs. Okay, that's a nice thing. And this here, the Scorpion King, the machine can cut down trees. That thing just looks amazing. It looks a beast. What else we got? Telehandlers. We've got a telehandler. Loads of attachments. Cool. Chainsaws. We can buy ourselves a decent chainsaw. McCulloch, Lonsered, and Husqvarna. Probably go for McCulloch so I can pronounce it. It's the same price. And then we got Misk. So we got a low loader, we got a mobile water tank, and a mobile fuel tank. awesome. Well, there we go, peeps. I know it's a bit short. I'm sorry, but I wanted to show the three things off. In the next episode, we're going to get this field done, and we're going to start fertilizing this field, and maybe look at selling some of our crops to get some money, and then we can buy ourselves a chainsaw and try chopping down trees. You know, I haven't tried that yet, and it's something I want to get into fairly soon, because I'm quite excitable. But thank you very much for watching. My name is Stockoglaws. This is Farming Simulator 2015. I'm going to go dress up as a vampire, so follow me on Twitter if you want to see some pictures. I'll be putting some pictures up there and hopefully scaring you all on Halloween. So have a great day, have a great night, and take care and ciao for now. Bye bye. Thank you.